Hello dear students, welcome to another new session of IIT PAL for Biology. I am Rikisha Bhaumik, PGT Biology at Kendriya Vidyalaya Sector 2 RK Puram, New Delhi. Today in this session we will do a comprehensive study of a typical representative of the class Insecta. Yes, you have rightly guessed, as this particular representative is in your syllabus of class 11th. So today we will study about the morphology and anatomy of cockroach. In today's session we will study about the general features of a cockroach, its classification, the body parts, how it is divided, the mouth parts, its legs and wings. We will study about the elementary canal, the anatomy of the elementary canal of cockroach, as well as the blood vascular system. So let us begin first with the dorsal and ventral side. By now you must have acquainted yourself with the biological terms which we use while we are studying a typical animal. So what do you mean by the dorsal and ventral side? As you can see in this picture, the dorsal side is the side which is the upper one and it is far away from the ground, and the ventral one is the lower surface which is closer to the ground. For instance, in our case, our back represents the dorsal side and the belly region, the front part, is the ventral side. So you must know the meaning of the dorsal and ventral side. If I represent like this, this is the dorsal side which is away from the ground, and this one is the ventral side which is closer to the ground, right? Next, moving on to some general features of cockroach. Before we explore on it, let us see a diagram. This is the diagram of a cockroach, and now one by one we can explore the general features which are present in a cockroach. Number one, it is a typical representative of the class Insecta. By typical representative, I mean that it shows almost all the features of class Insecta, and that is why we are studying about cockroach, particularly from among the members of the class Insecta. Its shape, as you can see, is narrow and elongated, and it is compressed dorso-ventrally. It is elongated and it is compressed dorso-ventrally. Coming to the symmetry, we know that bilateral symmetry is seen. Do you remember what do you mean by the bilateral symmetry? Symmetry can be of two types in organism: radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. When we are talking about bilateral symmetry, we say that the body of an organism can be divided into two equal halves by only one plane. For instance, if we divide or try to cut the organism with the help of an imaginary line, then the left and right will be equal only with the help of one plane. If we cut this like this or this or like this, then the body parts will not show symmetry. So it is showing bilateral symmetry, which means that the body of the organism can be divided into two equal halves by only one plane. Coming to its size, the size is about 1/4 of an inch to 3 inches. So it can vary. The various species of the cockroach can vary from 0.6 to 7.6 centimeter. Next, color. You must have seen cockroaches mostly of reddish brown in color, but bright yellow, red, green have also been reported in tropical regions. What about its habit? Where does it live? It prefers to live in damp and warm places, and you can find it everywhere. Especially, it is a domestic pest, and it can be commonly found in houses, in the kitchen, in the canteens, in the hospitals, and wherever damp and warm conditions are present for its existence and there is a lot of food, it will be found there. Next, it is nocturnal and omnivorous. What do you mean by nocturnal? It shows its activity during night. It is active during night and it is omnivorous. It can eat almost everything, right? Omnivorous means it can feed on herbs, on plants as well as on smaller insects and animals. It is cosmopolitan in distribution. It is found all over the world except the polar regions. They have a long antenna. You can see here a pair of long antenna. There are legs. You can see three pairs of legs and a flat extension of the upper body wall that conceals the head. So, in this diagram, what you can conclude, you can see or you can infer that the body is narrow, elongated, dorsoventrally flattened. It has a pair of eyes. These eyes are compound eyes. Then there is a pair of antenna. There are three pair of legs, each coming from three different segments of the thorax region. We will come to this, that the body can be divided into three parts, and there are two pair of wings, as you can see. We will explore more about these features in our coming session. Next, about 2600 species of cockroaches are known, and this cockroach is supposed to have arisen many years ago, and it has a high adaptability because of which it has survived many catastrophes. It is said to be older than even the dinosaurs. The two species which are commonly found in India are number one Periplinata americana and the other is Blatta orientalis. These are the two species of cockroach which are commonly found in India. So, in this picture you can see the different species of cockroach. This is Blatella germanica, this is Blatella orientalis, Periplinata americana, the most common one seen in India, and Periplinata australasia, and this one is Periplinata brunia. So, these are the different species of cockroach, and about 2600 species of cockroach are known till today. Among these species, we will particularly focus on the study of the most common cockroach seen in India, which is the Periplinata americana. It is commonly known as American cockroach or ship cockroach because it has transported along with the humans in the ships and has spread throughout the different parts of the world with the humans. Here you can see the general picture of Periplinata americana. I know all of you must have seen this insect. Let's come to the classification first. Before we start its study, we should do a classification. We should know in which all phylum class it has been placed. It is under the phylum Arthropoda, which is the largest phylum of the animal kingdom. The class is Insecta. Order is Orthoptera. Genus is Periplinata and species is Americana. So, you must remember the classification of the cockroach, American cockroach, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Orthoptera, genus Periplinata and species Americana. It is a native of tropical America and has spread throughout the world, as I told you earlier. Now, coming to the morphology of the male and female cockroach, as you can see in this picture. Can you spot the differences between them? You can see that the body of male is slightly narrower as compared to the female. And there are some more differences which we will point out in our further discussion. The body, it measures about 4 centimeter in length. Both the sexes, they bear well developed wings. In males, but there is a difference between the male and the female wing. In the males, the wings extend beyond the tip of the abdomen, as you can see here, but that is not so in the case of females. So, by looking at the wings of the cockroach, you can also decipher whether it is a male or a female cockroach. Then it is oviparous, means it is egg laying. It is dioecious, two separate sex organs in separate individuals are present, and they exhibit parental care. By parental care, I mean that they will lay their eggs in a very secure and protected place, and they can also show parenting by providing food to it and by providing protection to the younger ones. So, a great degree of parental care is also seen in these cockroaches. Next, coming to the exoskeleton, the entire body of cockroach is covered by a hard brown colored exoskeleton. You must be knowing about skeleton, the endoskeleton and the exoskeleton. Endoskeleton comprises of the bone and exoskeleton is seen in some of the insects, which is an outer tough layer of chitin. So, it is an outer tough layer of chitin, brown in color, and in each segment the exoskeleton has hardened plates called sclerites. So, in this picture you can see the side view of the cockroach, and you can see that there are first of all we will again go to the basic description of the body structure. A pair of antenna, compound eyes, this is the head. Pronotum is the extension of the exoskeleton which is covering the head also. Then this is the wing, right? Then there are the three pair of legs, and this is the abdominal structure. So, the exoskeleton, they has hardened plates. These are plates, and instead of sclerites you see two terms, tergites and sternites, right? So, in the dorsal side, the sclerites are known as tergites. And on the ventral side, the sclerites are known as sternites. There are some sclerites on the lateral side also, which are known as pleurites. And each segment, these are the segments. We know that in arthropods, in insect, there is segmentation seen in the body. Which organism or which phylum shows a distinguished metamerism or segmentation? It is the annelida. But apart from annelid, in arthropods also there is a peculiar segmentation which is known as metamerism. So, these segments, the presence of segments on the body, or the body is in the form of segments or rings, is known as metamerism. And on these segments there are four sclerites. Each segment has four sclerites, and four sclerite comprises of the tergites and the sternites. Right, and these two, the tergites, sternites and pleurites, they are joined together by a thin and flexible membrane which is known as articular or arthrodial membrane. I hope it is clear. So, this part is showing the exoskeleton, the outer skeleton like structure, the hard rigid covering, brown color, composed of chitin. And each segment has sclerites. The dorsally the sclerites are known as tergites, and ventrally they are known as sternites, and they are attached together with the help of arthrodial membrane. What is the function of the exoskeleton in insects? Yes, you are right. The function include protection of the body. It also helps in prevention of unnecessary water loss from their body, because they live in dry terrestrial conditions. And they also serve as point for attachment of the muscles. So, these are the basic functions of the exoskeleton. In this picture again you can see what I have shown you, the tergites and sternites. As I earlier told you that there is segmentation all over the body, and the body can be divided into head, thorax and abdomen. So, this portion is the head. If we label it like this, this portion is the head, and then the thorax, you can see the three, and thorax is also divided into three parts, which is, this one is the prothorax, then this one is the mesothorax, and this one is the metathorax, right? And then these are the abdominal segment. So, the body can be categorized into or divided into three main parts, which is the head, thorax, and the rest is abdomen. We will again learn more about this in our further discussion. So, we coming back to the segmentation, a clear cut segmentation is seen in the body. You can see clear cut segmentation. I have shown this, the segmentation over the body, except at the head. At the head region, it is believed that in the embryonic stages there were 6 segments which got fused, but in the adults no segmentation is seen on the head region, and the thorax and abdomen they show segmentation. In an adult cockroach, the thorax they consist of 3 segments and abdomen has 10 segments. As I told you that the thorax can be divided into 3 parts on the basis of the 3 segments: prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. And the abdomen they has 10 segments. I have mentioned the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So whenever you draw the diagram of a cockroach to show its morphology, you should be illustrating clearly the 3 regions, the 3 thorax, the 3 segments of the thorax and the 10 segments of the abdomen, and the head over it having the compound eyes and the pair of antenna. Next, moving on to the head. So, we will be studying about them one by one: the head, then thorax and then abdomen. As you can see in this picture, this is the side view of the head of a cockroach, and the shape of the head is triangular or ovate in shape. It is a bit triangular in shape or oval or ovate type. It is flattened anteroposteriorly and lies at right angles to the longitudinal body axis. So, it is again flattened anteroposteriorly and it lies at right angles to the longitudinal body axis. Suppose this is the body axis, then it lies at right angles, the head lies at right angles like this. It is formed by the fusion of 6 embryonic segments, but in the adults no more segmentation over the head region is seen. And the head is highly mobile in all direction because it has a short but flexible neck which allows to move its head in all direction. Now, if we see the front portion of the head of the cockroach in its dorsal view, then we can see that the head bears a pair of compound eyes. This is the pair of compound eyes which I have shown, a pair of antenna, and appendages are also found around the mouth, which we will discuss when we learn about the mouth parts of cockroach. The top of the head capsule, this head can be said to be in the form of a capsule. So, this portion, the pink color you see, is showing you the vertex. The different regions have been categorized and named. So, this one, the top region, the top of the head capsule, which is represented by the pink color, is the vertex. Then next, the next region which you see in the yellow color below the vertex is a frons, which is anterior to this frons is anterior to the vertex, and anterior to the frons is again a region which is known as clypeus, which I have shown in dark blue color. Next, the lower part of the clypeus, which is the light blue in color, is the labrum or the upper lip. Labrum will form the part of the mouth part of the cockroach. So, these are the different region. You can see ocelli also. These are referred to as simple eyes, but they are only sensory in function. A pair of compound eyes, a pair of antenna. The top region is known as the vertex, below which is a frons, and below which is the clypeus, and interior to this is the labrum, and on the side you can see a pair of mandibles. These two comprises the mouth part which we will study in our further session, and this region between the compound eye and the clypeus is known as the jejuna. So, these are the different parts of the head region of cockroach when we view it dorsally. Next, moving on to the eyes, the eyes show very interesting and peculiar character in the case of cockroaches. The eyes are basically compound eyes. The head capsule, they bear a pair of compound eyes. They are sessile, black and kidney shaped structures. A compound eye of a cockroach consists of about 2000 visual unit or omatidia. So, here you can see the vertical section of a compound eye. So, actually the compound eye, it comprises of many smaller units. They have been congregated together to form a compound eye, and one compound eye comprises of such 2000 units. So, this entire unit we can say it as an ommatidia. This is an ommatidia and one compound eye comprises of about 2000 such ommatidia. It is the basic unit of the compound eye. Now, what does this ommatidia consist of? Like every eye, the structure of eye should have a lens, should have a cornea, should have a cone. The ommatidium also consists of a biconvex lens, a transparent crystalline cone, light sensitive visual cells and pigment cell. Here you can see the lens, the upper region, it is the lens or the cornea, right? And then you can see the ommatidia. This is the basement membrane and these are the optic nerves. The nerves, these are known as the optic nerves because they are associated with the functioning of eyes, right? If we magnify this image of one ommatidium and we see the longitudinal section of an ommatidium, it is like this. This is the corneal lens, the layer which is the corneal lens. Below it are the corneagian cell. These corneagian cell, they secrete the cornea. Then there is a crystalline cone like structure which again acts as a second lens. Then you can see the black region is the rhabdome, which is a cylindrical refractive part, and this is the retinular cell which helps in secreting the rhabdome. This is the basement membrane and these are the nerves which will join with the optic nerve. So, this is the structure of an ommatidium and a compound eye of a cockroach, it comprises of many ommatidium. So, you can see an image like that of pixels, many small, small dots if seen together, they comprise one compound eyes. So, this is a very peculiar feature of a compound eye. Each ommatidium is capable of producing an independent image of a small part of the object and not the entire object. So, each of these ommatidium, they will form images, they will form individual images and there will be a combined image. And such kind of vision is known as mosaic vision, in which there is images being formed in patches in all the ommatidia. So, all these small images, they are combined in the brain to form a complete image of the object that is made of small dots or mosaic of dots. So, it shows a mosaic like pattern and therefore, this kind of vision is also known as mosaic vision. This is also a characteristic feature of the compound eye in cockroach, that they show mosaic vision. One more important thing is that these eyes are more sensitive, they can sense the different things or the different objects around, especially they can sense the motion. They can sense the objects which are in motion rather than those objects which are at rest. They can easily find out that some objects are in motion. So, they are very sensitive, but the resolution power is very less and therefore, they are nocturnal. They are active during night. By resolution, I mean to clearly distinguish between the various parts of a picture you are seeing. So, they have less resolution, they cannot distinguish between all the part of the image, but the eyes are very sensitive, they can even sense the objects which are moving or the objects which are in motion. These are the features of the compound eyes of cockroach. I hope this is clear, right. Now, next moving on to the antenna. We have learned that there is a pair of antenna which arise from the membranous socket. One on the either side below the eyes. So, if I draw a structure of antenna, so the antenna it arises from a socket which is known as antennal socket. Then there is a swollen base like structure, again one more swollen structure, and then there are different flagellum, which are like arranged like this. And there are bristles or sensillae over these flagellums. right. So, we can label it as this is the socket, antennal socket. And this swollen base is known as scape. The portion above it is known as pedicel. These two act as the base of the antenna, and these parts are the flagellum, and they comprise of the bristles or sensillaries, which can sense the environment around. It can sense the particles, the food particles or the insects or potential danger. So, this is the filiform, this is also known as filiform type of antennae, which is seen in the case of cockroaches. So, each antenna has three parts: a large basal scape, a smaller pedicel, and a long filamentous many jointed flagellum. These are many jointed flagellum, and this type of an antenna which has a jointed flagellum is known as filiform antenna. The antenna possess small sensory bristles which are known as sensillae, and they can be moved in all directions. These are the tactoreceptors, they can receive the physical object, they can sense the physical objects around, as well as olfactory receptors to smell, so that they can find out food in the environment, which help in monitoring the environment and locating its food. So, the function of antenna is to monitor its environment, whether it is safe or not, and also it helps in locating its food, because they have receptors, these sensillae, they have receptors, they are tactile receptors and olfactory receptors, they can sense and smell the objects around. Now, we have done the head region, we have learnt about the compound eyes, we have learnt about the antennae. Now, we will learn about the mouth parts of cockroach, and this subtopic is important from the examination viewpoint also, because many questions come in your exams related to this topic. So, the mouth part of cockroach comprises of various parts. The anterior end of the head, they bear appendages forming biting and chewing type of mouth part. This is very important, you should remember that the mouth part in cockroach is said to be of biting and chewing type. The mouth part, they consist of a labrum, upper lip, a labium, which is the lower lip, a pair of mandibles, a pair of maxillae, and a median flexible lobe, which act as tongue or hypopharynx. It lies within the cavity enclosed by the mouth part. So, these are the mouth part. First, you should be able to enlist the name of the mouth part. Number one, the labrum, which act as the upper lip, then labium, which act as the lower lip, a pair of mandible, a pair of maxilla, and a median flexible lobe, which act as a tongue, known as hypopharynx. So, these are the five parts, five mouth parts: labrum, labium, mandible, maxillae, hypopharynx. I hope you will be able to name them. Now, we will be discussing about them one by one. First of all, labrum. Labrum looks like this. This is the structure. It is a membranous flat lobe which is suspended below the clypeus. I told you about the clypeus when we learnt about the dorsal regions of the head of the cockroach. So, there is a clypeus, and below the clypeus there is a labrum, which is a membranous flat lobe. It lies in front of the mouth as the upper lip. It acts like an upper lip. On its ventral surface, many sensory setae are situated. You can see here, these are the setae. Again, they are sensory in function, and they have gustatoreceptors. What are gustatoreceptors? They act like a taste bud. They help in telling the taste of a particular object. So, on the ventral surface, they have sensory setae, and they act as gustatoreceptors. Next, moving on to labium. As you can see in the picture, the labium looks like this. This is the lower lip, which is lying behind the mouth, and it has two regions, the proximal postmentum and a distal prementum. This is the prementum region which you can see, and this entire region is known as postmentum. And this postmentum is again divided into two regions, as you can see clearly in this diagram, submentum and mentum, a larger submentum and a smaller mentum. So, the labium can be divided into two parts, postmentum, which is distal, and a proximal prementum. On each side, it has a three jointed labial palps. You can see here, these are the labial palps, and three jointed, 1, 2, 3. So, there are three jointed palps, which are known as labial palps. Then you can see that between the labial palps, there are four lobes, two median and smaller glossae are there. This is the median and smaller glossae, and two outer and larger paraglossae are present here. So, this is the basic structure of the labium. Again, let us recap this, that the labium is acting as the lower lip. It can be divided into two parts, postmentum and prementum. Postmentum can again be divided into submentum and mentum region. Then there are labial palps, and there is a smaller lobes which are known as glossae, which is interior, and outer to it are broader paraglossa. So, it act as a lower lip. Again, these palps are sensory in function, they can sense the food around. Next, coming on to the mandibles, as you can see in this picture, and you can guess what the function can be. You can see here that they have claw like structure, which are the biting edges. They have teeth like structure, which are the biting edges, right. So, these act like teeth, they help in chewing the food. So, a pair of mandible, they suspend from either side of the mouth. Each mandible is stout and have teeth lying cutting plates at its inner edge. These are used for crushing and cutting the food. Next, coming on to the maxillae, the maxilla is present in pairs on either side of the head capsule and behind the mandible. It is behind the mandible. Each maxilla has a basal protopodite having cardo ends types. You can see this is the basal area, which is divided into cardo ends types, and they are bent at right angle to each other. From the inner side of these type, from this inner side of these type, you can see a five jointed maxillary palp. Just like we saw the labial palp, in maxilla also there is a palp. Palps are always sensory in function. These are five jointed, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, these are five jointed maxillary palp. The maxilla, what is the function? They help in holding the food together by its claw like structure and bring it to the mandibles for further mastication and chewing of the food. So, we have discussed about the labium, labrum, mandibles and maxillae. Labrum, labium, they are acting as upper lips and lower lips. Then the mandibles, which act like teeth, they help in crushing and chewing of the food. And then the maxilla, which helps in bringing the food closer to the mandible in order for it to masticate it. Next, the hypopharynx. Hypopharynx is, this is the picture of a hypopharynx, which looks similar to the structure of a tongue. It lies between the maxilla, and in front of the labium. It is a flat cylindrical structure. The common salivary duct, this is the common salivary duct, which opens at the base of the hypopharynx. And you know that the function of salivary gland is to secrete enzymes in order for the food to be digested. So, again we can summarize the mouth parts of the cockroach which we have learned. This is the labrum, the upper lip, labium, the lower lip having the labial palps, then the mandibles which have the grinding or incising region, they help in mastication of food, the hypopharynx in between the mandible, and these are the maxilla, which will help in collecting and bringing the food closer to the mandible, right? I hope the mouth parts of cockroach is pretty clear to you, right? Next, move on to the thorax. So, we have described a lot about the head region, we have learnt about the various regions of the head, we have learnt about the pair of compound eyes, we have learnt about the structure of antenna, we have learnt about the mouth parts, which is also a part of the head. Now, next we will move on to the thorax. So, thorax is basically the chest region, and again I will take you back to the diagram which I showed you earlier. This one is the basic diagram where I told you that this is the thorax region, and the thorax region can be divided into three segments: prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. Each segment they bear a pair of walking legs. So, now coming to the legs, which I didn't tell you earlier, the legs are present in each of the segment, of the thorax. That means, the prothorax bears a pair of legs, the mesothorax bear a pair of legs, and the metathorax bear a pair of legs. So, there are three pair of legs, each arising from each of the segment of the thorax region. The prothorax also has a large pronotum, which covers the head also partially. The head is connected with the thorax by a short extension of prothorax. A short extension of prothorax, which comprises the neck and holds the head and thorax region together. So, neck is like a connection between the head and the thorax region, right? Okay. Next, moving on to the walking legs. So, we have learnt that it has a three pair of walking legs, but now we will study about the structure of the leg. So, similar three pair of legs are present in a cockroach for cursorial habit. Cursorial means they run very fast. For fast running habit, you must have seen cockroaches running very fast. This type of habit is known as cursorial habit, and they have similar three pair of legs for this. Each leg, they consist of five segments, five parts. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five parts are there in each of the leg. And what are those five parts? Coxa, trochanter, femur, which is also present in our legs. Then this is the tibia, which is thinner, the tarsus, and then there are claws. So, these are the five parts which comprises the leg of a cockroach. Next, moving on to the wings. As you can see in this picture, that there are two pair of wings, and these wings, they arise from the first pair, is also known as tegmina. As you can see, tegmina is nothing but the first pair of wings, and it arises from the mesothorax, and the second pair of wing, it arises from the metathorax. The forewing, also called tegmina, it is opaque. You can see it has been shaded dark in color because it is opaque, dark, leathery, and its purpose is to cover the hind wings when it rests. So, when the cockroach is at resting position, the tegmina will cover the entire body. Its function is to cover the entire body and protect it. The hind wings are the transparent membranous, and these are the wings which are used for flight, for flying. So, you know now the location of the wings. The wings, again coming back to this diagram, the wings, the first pair of wings arise from the mesothorax, and the second pair of wing arises from the metathorax. The three pair of legs, each arising from prothorax, mesothorax, metathorax, but the two pair of wings, they arise from the first one from the mesothorax and the second one from the metathorax. Now, moving on to the abdomen, we have discussed about head, we have discussed about the thorax region, we have seen that thorax can be divided into three parts: prothorax, mesothorax, metathorax, and we have seen about the legs, There are three pair of walking legs, each arising from each of the segment of the thorax, and two pair of wings. Next, we will move on to the abdomen. I told you that there are 10 segments in the abdomen of a cockroach, both male and female, they consist of 10 segments in the abdomen. Let us see the difference, or let us learn about the abdomen in male and abdomen in female. In male, the genital pouch lies at the hind end of abdomen, bounded dorsally by the 9th and 10th terga and ventrally by the 9th sternum. I hope by now you know what we mean by terga and what we know by sternum, right? So, the genital pouch, it lies at the hind end of the abdomen, and these are bounded by the 9th and 10th segment, 9th and 10th terga ventrally, and by the 9th sternum. It contains the dorsal anus, ventral male genital pore, and gonapophysis. About this, we will study in our next session when we discuss the reproductive system of cockroach. But for now, you need to remember the location, that the genital pouch, it is located between the 9th and 10th segment, and it comprises of the dorsal anus, ventral male genital pore, and gonapophysis. In females, the 7th sternum is boat shaped, and together with the 8th and the 9th sternum, it forms a brood or genital pouch. So, the genital pouch in male was comprised by the 9th and 10th segment, but in the case of female, it is comprising, it comprises of the 7th, 8th and 9th sternum. Its anterior part contains the female gonopore, spermatheca pores and collateral glands. Again, this we will discuss when we study the female reproductive system of a cockroach. But for now, you need to remember the location of the reproductive system or the genital pouch in the case of male and female. I hope this is clear. In both sexes, the 10th segment bears a pair of jointed filamented structures called anal cerci. So, in both these sexes, the 10th segment, it bears a pair of jointed filamentous structure, which is known as anal cerci, which we will discuss. Now, coming to sexual dimorphism. What do you mean by sexual dimorphism? Sexual dimorphism is when we can clearly demarcate between the sexes of an organism, that this is male, this is a female. Likewise, in cockroaches also, by seeing at the body of the cockroach, we can find out whether it is a male or a female cockroach, if you have studied about it. So, what are the features of the male and female cockroach? Number one point of difference is the body size of the male cockroach is smaller than the female, and females are relatively larger in size. Abdomen of the male cockroach is slender, but abdomen of the female cockroach is broad and boat shaped. Wings are larger and extend beyond the abdomen, which we saw previously, that the wings, they are larger in size and they extend beyond the abdomen in case of males, but that is not so in the case of females, wings are smaller. A pair of short thread like anal styles are present in the male cockroach, which is absent in the female. In a female cockroach, the 7th sternum is produced backward to form a keel like structure. Let us try to understand all this with the help of this diagram. You can see the abdomen in cockroach, the male and the female, it is showing from the 6th to 10th segment. The first difference which you can make out is that there is anal style which is present in male, but it is absent in female, right? And this is the dorsal view. When we see the dorsal view, we can see this, that anal style are present in males, but not in females. And when we see ventrally, we will see that the anal style is arising from the 9th sternum in the males. And in the females, when we see ventrally, we see that a rounded, this is a rounded keel like structure which is formed due to the folding backward of the 7th sternum. So, by looking at this, we can make out that this is a female cockroach. Next, moving on to the elementary canal. So, till now we have discussed about the basic morphology, the basic division of the body into various parts and their structure. Now, we will move on to the anatomy of elementary canal. So, we will be restricting ourselves in this topic with only the anatomy, not the physiology of the elementary canal, which is in your syllabus. So, the diagram here represents the elementary canal. The elementary canal can be divided into three regions, as you can see here, foregut, which is also known as stomodium, midgut or mesenteron, and the hindgut, which is also known as proctodium. So, what foregut or stomodium comprises of? The mouth or the buccal cavity, which opens into a short tubular pharynx. Then there is a slender food pipe, narrow tubular passage known as esophagus. And this esophagus opens into a sac like structure, which is known as crop. And then the function of crop is to store the food. It helps in storing of the food. Below the crop, again a small sac like structure is present, which is known as gizzard or proventriculus. What is the function of gizzard? It helps in additional grinding of the food, which has been masticated by the mandibles, and then the food which is stored here in the crop region, they will additionally be grinded in the gizzard. What helps in this grinding? The gizzard, it has an outer layer of thick circular muscles and thick inner cuticle, forming six highly chitinous plate called teeth. So, it has an outer layer of thick circular muscle and an inner thin cuticle, which forms six highly chitinized, made up of chitin plate, which acts like the teeth, and it helps in grinding of the food. So, gizzard helps in grinding the food particles. The entire foregut is lined by cuticle. The entire foregut, this is the foregut, mouth, pharynx, esophagus, crop, gizzard, all this is the foregut, and this is lined by the cuticle in order to protect the parts. Midgut or mesenteron, this portion which you see in orange is the midgut, and you can see that it is demarcated by two junctions on either side. At the junction of the foregut and the midgut, you see that there is a presence of 6 to 8 blind tibules. What do you mean by a blind tibule? Blind tibule has only one opening and it is closed at the other end. So, these are the blind tibules, and these blind tibules are the hepatic cecum. These hepatic cecum, also known as gastric cecum, they release digestive enzymes, digestive juices in order for the food to be digested. So, the food then passes from the midgut into the hindgut. But before passing into the hindgut, we see again that there are certain thread like structures which are known as malpighian tubules. They do not have any role in digestion, but they help in excretion. We will come to this later. So, the hind gut, from the mid gut, you can see the hind gut, it has broadened. So, whenever you draw the diagram, you have to broaden the hind gut, because it is broader than the mid gut. At the junction, there are the tube 100 to 150 yellow colored thin filamentous malpighian tubules, whose function is excretory. It helps in excretory products from the hemolymph, which is the blood. Its interior region following the midgut is called ileum. The interior region of the hindgut, which is followed by this malpighian tubule, is the ileum. Then there is a coiled portion, which is known as colon, and then it again opens into a broader portion, which is known as rectum. Ileum, colon, rectum is the part of the hindgut, and this lie posteriorly below the 10th tergum. So, these are the various parts of the elementary canal: foregut, which is also known as stomodium, then midgut, and then the hindgut. Foregut comprises of the buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, crop, gizzard. Then there is hepatic cecum, which helps in digestion. Then there is the midgut, followed by the malpighian tubules, which will help in excretion. And then there is the hindgut, which comprises of ileum, colon, and rectum, followed by the anus. So, this is all about the elementary canal of the cockroach. Now, coming to the next important system, which is the blood vascular system. As you can see here in this diagram, you can see that the blood vascular system, they comprise of these chamber like structures, sac like structures, and there are certain set of muscles which are known as Ehlers muscles. And these sac like structures are actually the chamber of heart. And this is the anterior aorta, which directly continues with the chamber of heart. So, the blood vascular system or the circulatory system in cockroach is of open type. Open type means it is not very well developed, it does not have blood vessels and the blood is directly bathed into the tissues. The blood vessels, they are poorly developed and open into the space. The space is known as hemocele because the entire body cavity is the comprises of the blood. The blood is directly entering into the body cavity. So, this entire space or the cavity is known as hemocele. The visceral organs, the internal organs, they are located in this hemocele and they are directly bathed in blood. Blood is the hemolymph. Hemolymph is the blood in the case of cockroach. The hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma and hemocytes. So, the blood comprises of the colorless plasma and hemocytes, but there are no pigments. As in the case of humans, we know that hemoglobin is present, which is the pigment, and it helps in carrying the oxygen. But in this case, no pigment, that means there is no association with the oxygen. The role of blood is not to transport oxygen in the case of cockroaches. So, what is the function? Only to transport the food material. The heart is an elongated muscular tube. You can see it is an elongated muscular tube and consists of 13 segmentally arranged funnel shaped chambers. These are 13 segmentally arranged, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So, again when you are drawing the structure, you need to draw, you need to show 13 chambers, funnel shaped chambers of the heart. At the lateral side of each chamber is a pair of ostia, one on each side. So, if I show this particular chamber, so there is an ostia on either side. This is one ostia and this is the other ostia, and again now the next one will arise and there will be two ostia here. And the function of ostia, it is regulated by valves, right? These valves regulate the ostia. So, at the lateral side there is a pair of ostia, one on each side. These ostia are guarded by valves which allow the blood to only enter the heart. As you know, the function of valve is to allow the blood to enter into a particular direction and it closes so that it does not backflow, right? The first chamber of heart is continued anteriorly into an anterior aorta and the blood will flow into the head region through the anterior aorta. The alary muscles are 12 pairs. These are the alary muscles you can see. These will help in contraction and relaxation of this these chambers of the heart so that the blood flows properly to all the parts of the body. So, the alary muscles are helping in the contraction and relaxation, causing the blood to flow into the body. Blood from sinuses. Sinuses are the different spaces like perivisceral sinuses, pericardial sinuses. So, the different spaces, blood from different parts or the spaces, they enter into the heart through these ostia and is pumped anteriorly to sinuses again. Then it is pumped, so the ostia, the blood will enter through the ostia and also will be pumped out through this ostia into the various sinuses or spaces of the body parts. Now, so in this session, we have completed many topics. In this session, what we have learned? We have learned about the general features of a cockroach, the classification system of Periplanata americana. We have learned about the body parts, head, thorax and abdomen. We have learned about the mouth parts of cockroach. We have seen the structure of legs and the structure of wings and its origin. We have also learned about the elementary canal of cockroach and the blood vascular system of cockroach. Now, let us evaluate, let us try to answer these questions. What are the sclerites present in cockroach? As we have discussed, these are the exoskeleton which has hardened plates, and these hardened plates are called sclerites present on each segment. Dorsally they are known as tergites and ventrally they are known as sternites and laterally they are known as pleurites. Next question, which mouth part of cockroach is comparable to a tongue? Yes, right, very good. It is the hypopharynx, which looks like a tongue. Next question, give the location of hepatic ceca in a cockroach. What is their function? So, when we learnt about the alimentary canal, we saw that hepatic ceca is present at the junction of the foregut and the midgut, and it is in present in the form of a ring of 6 to 8 blind tubules, which are known as hepatic or gastric ceca. They secrete the digestive juices. Mention the special feature of eye in cockroach. It is, the special feature is that it is a compound eye which is formed of about 2000 visual units known as omatidia, and each unit forms an individual image of the object, and this type of image formation is known as mosaic vision. So, cockroaches show mosaic vision. Complete the following statement. In cockroach, grinding of food particle is performed by gizzard. Malpighiant tubule helps in the removal of, what does it do? In the removal of nitrogenous waste products. Hind gut of cockroach is differentiated into ileum, colon and rectum. In cockroach, blood vessels open into spaces which are also known as sinuses. So, these are the correct answer. I hope you were able to answer them correctly. Now, I am giving you certain questions to reflect over whatever you have learned. So, at your home, you will practice drawing a label diagram of alimentary canal of a cockroach. And the second question is, draw a label diagram of the blood vascular system of cockroach. Also, trace the course of circulation of blood. When you are drawing the diagram, please keep in mind the points which I told you. Be specific in diagram making. In our next session, we will continue with the remaining topics of this chapter, morphology and anatomy of cockroach. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.